Let's build an AI-powered Slack bot using OpenAI's GPT to answer any question you have. So for example, in Slack, let's say I @mention GPT and I say, what is the meaning of life? Deep question. Let's see what the AI thinks. So it's going to respond to my thread and, you know, I'm not actually a human, so I can't really deeply understand what the meaning of life is. You're going to have to figure that out yourself. Anyways, let's dig in and show how to build this example using Node.js and using Vercel functions. Okay, first, let's get our API keys and we'll set up our Slack configuration. So in OpenAI's platform, I've set up a new secret key and I've saved that value in my editor. And then inside of Slack, inside of configuring new applications, I went ahead and made this new app. So I created a new app. I'm just going to make it from scratch. I get to add it to whatever workspace I want and give it a name. And I've already done that and created this new application here. It's called Vercel GPT. So under OAuth and permissions, we're going to set up what scope the bot has access to and then get the token. So if you scroll down to scopes, I've added in some scopes here for our bot so it can get @mentioned. It can read and write messages in the channel. And then I've went ahead and saved that bot user OAuth token. So back under basic information, we're going to scroll down to app credentials. And we're going to have this signing secret. So this value, this secret value, is going to allow our application to verify the authenticity of the request coming in. So it's going to make sure that they're coming from Slack. So save this value. We're going to use it locally as well as when deployed to Vercel. Okay, so let's dig into the code. All of this will be available on GitHub and linked in the description, but I still want to walk through how the code works. So you can follow along here or you can just get started from the repository. So I have a simple application set up that is using the Slack web API and OpenAI Node.js SDK, and it's using a Vercel function. This Vercel function is going to be under the API folder. So when you drop a file inside of here, it's going to allow this application to expose an API route, so /API/events. So we're going to start there. Okay, so in this file, we have an asynchronous function that's exported. So we have this post function. And this means that it's only going to allow the HTTP method of post. So if we try a GET or a patch or a put, that's going to be a 405 method not found. This takes in the web request and it produces a web response. So you can use any of the familiar web APIs that you're used to. This is using Node.js 18 plus where these were included. So that's really helpful. Let's walk through this function and what it does. So we have the body of the incoming request and we check and see what type it is. If it's a verification type from Slack, we're just going to send back the challenge. This is how Slack's going to verify that we've basically configured things correctly. But then down here, we have this other block, which if this is a valid request from Slack, so we're going to do some comparison of the signature, then we're going to go ahead and process this event and call OpenAI. So let's jump into this function, is valid Slack request. We have a couple things here. We have the signing signature that we saved from earlier when setting up Slack. We read the different headers, so the timestamp, as well as the signature that Slack is expecting us to have. And then we can combine not only the timestamp, but the stringified body of the incoming request, use the Node.js crypto library in combination with that signing secret, and compute this signature. So this cryptographic signature, we can then compare that on the final line here. We can compare that with what we expect from Slack. If these two things are the same, then we have guaranteed the authenticity of this incoming request and we can proceed forward. So this prevents abuse of our API endpoint here. So if that is legit and that returns true, then we can continue. So we go down here. Okay, we have an event that is an app mention. So we've made a mention to our GPT bot. Well, let's send a response based on this event. And then we'll return back success. So let's pop into this method. Send GPT response. So it takes in this event. It has a couple things on the incoming event here, the channel, the timestamp, and the thread timestamp. And what we're going to do is we're going to use the Slack web API here to basically thread a conversation. So we have our channel, we have the thread timestamp, and we're going to include this in the thread. We take the thread and we are going to forward this to generate a prompt from the thread. We're going to get a response and then send it back. So this part right here, you could basically sub out with any AI provider you want, any large language model. You could use a RAG where you have retrieval augmented generation where you can upload documents. So maybe you want to train some custom model or pass in a bunch of additional information to a large language model so it can look up all of your docs. There's a bunch of different things you could do here. You could potentially have it return images as well too. Really, this is showing you the art of what is possible with using AI plus Slack. In this instance, we're going to keep it pretty simple, but you take this and we generate the response, and then we post a Slack message back to our thread. So now let's go one step further into what we're doing with OpenAI. So we have generate prompt from thread. So inside of here, essentially we're mapping over the messages. We're determining whether it's a bot. And if it's the bot, we're going to change the information that we return back. So it's either the assistant, aka OpenAI, or it's the user. And then we also have this call here, get GPT response, which is effectively just a small wrapper around calling the OpenAI Node.js SDK. So we use the completions API. We're going to use the 3.5 turbo model, which is faster. It's a little bit cheaper. If you want to get a higher quality response, you can use GPT-4 or maybe some newer models in the future as well too. And then we're passing along the messages. So we've kind of formatted the messages in the format that OpenAI expects, and then we return it back here. This is really all that you need to, you know, talk to OpenAI. We could abstract this out. We could use other providers if we want. We could use Vercel's AI SDK, which is going to give a more generic format for this. Really, you can do whatever you want here, but we return back this GPT response. We go here and it posts the message back to the channel. So just to show an example of this one more time, if I say GPT, what is Next.js? This call is going to go to Slack. Slack's going to take this webhook. It's going to ping our deployed API. It's going to forward that information in the web request. So comes and it brings in that web request. It's going to talk to OpenAI, compute the response, and it says Next.js is a popular React framework and so on and so forth. So it's pretty incredible how you can stitch these services together using just HTTP and really using the power of Node.js here to construct a pretty helpful utility. Now, how did our Slackbot know what URL to talk to? We didn't cover that in the start, and that's because we needed to actually have our application deployed. So back in our Slackbot settings, under event subscriptions, we can put in the request URL. So I have this demo URL that I've been working with here, /API/events. So remember, the file format or the file system format is going to determine what the URL endpoint is. So I dropped that in here, and then I needed to subscribe to some bot events. So added a couple things here, app mention, and then message channels, and hit save. And when you hit save, it's going to ask you to reinstall the bot, which is fine. It just updates it based on these subscriptions. And that's really all that you need to do to configure the most basic setup inside of your Slackbot. To get your site online, you can deploy in the CLI using Vercel. And if you don't already have it installed, you can use your favorite package manager. Let's say it's npm i-g Vercel. So if you run Vercel or you push to your Git repository, you can get your site online, you get your new URL. And we can actually go back to Vercel's logs and just verify that things are working correctly. So I've opened up the logs for my project, and you see I've made a bunch of post requests to API events directly coming from Slack. So let's say I click on this one. We see it's a post. We see the URL. It's a 200. On the right-hand side, I can see more information about it. And if I scroll down, I see that we've configured it. It's using Node.js. We've changed the maximum duration the function can run. I'll talk about that in a second. And then we also see on our paid plans, there's these request metrics that we have early access to. So it took about 90 milliseconds to call Slack there, about 1.8 seconds from OpenAI, and then another 96 to call again. So that's kind of cool, so you can see what's happening behind the scenes. I mentioned max duration, and I quickly want to show that. So inside of API/events, that file that's constructing our API route here, I exported this configuration option for my route. So there's a number of config options you can use here. One of them is configuring the maximum amount of time that your functions can run. Depending on the plan you're on, this probably starts at 15 seconds. So if you're doing some kind of AI logic that's going to take a decent chunk of time, you might want to up this max duration. So definitely go read our docs to see more about max duration, but just wanted to quickly mention that might be something you want to configure depending on what you're building. All right, so that wraps up this video, making a AI-powered Slackbot using OpenAI's GPT and Vercel Functions through Node.js. I want to give a shout out to Jawan, who made this really interesting example, very similar to this, that I kind of forked and changed up a little bit, but this was a lot of the inspiration for this video. So thank you, and thanks for putting this code out on open source. If you liked this video and you made it this far and you want to see more AI content, give us a thumbs up or leave a subscribe and let us know in the comments what you'd like to see. Peace.